Now let's talk about text in Designer. Text is something that you will find in any software that can create templates and output of any kind. You need text to go around your variable data because only variable data generally doesn't make much sense. Now here's the fact. Designer works with HTML. Everything that we do inside of the Designer application is HTML along with CSS and JavaScript. If you've worked with HTML CSS in the past, you may be excited by this because you probably know that both in combination can be really, really powerful, especially if you add scripts and JavaScript on top of it. But first, let's just start at the basics and add a couple of paragraphs and a header to our template. So what we have now is just a header, a couple of paragraphs, and a date appearing in the end. So it could be kind of the equivalent of a simple letter, something that is very easy to do in Connect Designer. And because Connect Designer works with a page-based design or an overflowing design, when you add more text to your page, it'll react kind of like Microsoft Word. So let me add just a bunch of text to show you how that works. So I've added some nonsensical lorem ipsum text to my page. And when I go a bit lower to see the end of the page, the text automatically overflows to the new page. Now, this is the beauty of how print output especially works in the Connect Designer. The overflow is all automatic. It does it with text, it does it with images, it does it with tables, it does it with everything that you put in the software. Now, how do we style text? Because we use CSS, there's a couple of cool things that we can do with it, but the basics are all there. You want to put something in bold, you just select it, and you hit the bold key, and that gives you bold text. The same is true for italic, underline, strike through, or anything else that you apply to a text selection. Now you can also add styling to any element on your page. So the first header, the paragraph, etc. If you right click on any element, it'll give you a couple of options. The first ones are scripting options. The next ones are generally about formatting. So here paragraph will bring up the paragraph formatting dialog. So this is where you would set anything that affects the whole paragraph. So if I want to add a border to the paragraph, that works. Now, of course, this is only affecting the paragraph that I selected. So basically, any text modification you want to do in your template is the same as any other text editor. We're not reinventing the wheel. It's all the same everywhere. The difference is that any change that you make is made inside of the HTML and or CSS. So if we take a look really quickly at the source code, well, what you see is the HTML code. This is the heart of the web. It's what your browser actually sees when you're visiting websites. So in the case of the paragraph where we added the border style, this is added through a style which is CSS. And in the case of the bold, it's added with the B tag, which is the tag for bold in HTML. If you know your HTML and CSS, again, this is pretty familiar to you, pretty basic. You can just paste your own HTML in here and it's going to work. Otherwise, using the interface is a good way to get you started on how to style all your text and all your elements on the page.